Hello, veteran 0121 here, welcome back. This is another episode, Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. In the last episode, I was exploring the... whatever the hell this place is called. It's a Dwemer ruin. Basically, I gotta take these lexicons to the deeper reaches of this place. I did get my alchemy up to 100. I maxed it out by just fucking around making potions. As you can see, I got the advanced lab perk, which is pretty identical to the arcane enchanter perk in the enchanter tree. And it functions just the same. And before I forget, Sophia,
do you have something to say?
Can you get the fuck away from the arcane enchanter,
right,
please?
Then.
Or the thing? Get away from it. Someone else is using this. I'm using it. Basically, what you gotta do, you gotta go into sneak mode and you gotta disassemble it. So.
I know what you're up to. And yeah. It would be hypocritical of me.
Anyway. Yeah, I made like, I don't know, I guess I could try poisoning the Dawnbreaker to see what happens. Increases the target's magic regeneration by 100% for 48 seconds. One-handed weapons do 39% more damage for 60 seconds. Health is increased by 58 points for 60 seconds. So, yeah, this is just one of the many poisons I was able to make while I was making potions. I made a lot of potions. A lot of them I'm going to use, and some of them are just junk that I'm either going to use later, or just throw away, or what have you, whatever.
Say anything.
I suppose I could also poison the, do I have any two-hander poison? I don't think I have any two-hander poison. I've got a paralysis. You can put that on there. Or slow. Poisonous slow with damaging the target's health. Yeah, why not? I don't know how long these poisons last. I have no idea. I suppose I could keep some of them around, though.
What is it? Do I have a choice? Well, okay, but you owe me.
Yeah, that one damages magic regen.
Huh, you're no fun.
Yeah, for a second there, I thought I was putting them in storage, but that was not storage. That frenzy. That'll basically make targets crazy, and they'll just, they'll just fucking attack anything, really. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna keep those around. These I'm gonna get rid of. Yeah, potions, they take up a lot of space. Extreme stamina, fortify. But yeah, I was able to make some block potions. How many? Keep about 5 on hand, maybe. That should be good. No, I don't want that one. Don't want that one. Yeah, I made some conjuration potions. Just, again, just to raise... I just wanted to raise the skill and... The ingredients that I had weren't useful for anything else. I figured, why the hell not? So get rid of those. Get rid of these. destruction, same thing. Get rid of those. Yeah, this potion right here, as you can see, it's worth a lot. I actually mixed a boar tusk and a giant's toe. I remember this one specifically because I was so surprised by it. But yeah, that's actually quite a lot of health. I mean, it actually probably more worth it to fucking sell it, to be quite honest. If you want my honest opinion. Got lockpicking, fortify magicka, fortify war magicka, marksman. Yeah, this one, yeah, that's 49%, and I got a bunch of 50% ones. One-handed ones. Eh. Eh. Got some smithing potions that I might take advantage of later. Sneaking, I don't really care about. Again, it's just one of those deals where I was just looking for stuff to make. Okay, two-handed. These are ones that I had before. This one right here is like the best two-handed potion I can make. As far as what ingredients it took, well, you just kind of have to like trial and error yourself. I mean, it definitely did help being able to eat the ingredients to get all the effects of it. Because basically what you want to do is you want to look for an ingredient that has an effect and then look for an ingredient that has the same effect. And if you find three ingredients that have the same effect, sometimes you can get multiple effects in the same potion. So, there you go. Now, as you can see, I got like a ton of these. Actually, I don't want those. Those are like the crappier versions. And these are good, but I'll go with the better versions, I guess. Wait, those aren't the better versions. Whatever. It's confusing. Oh, yeah, and I made a whole bunch of invisibility potions, too. Maybe someday I'll use them, maybe not, but they're there if I want to use them or sell them or. But invisibility potions are good for raising your alchemy. And they're really good to sell, too. Oh, yeah, and I made a whole bunch of regenerate health potions. I don't know how many. I probably won't use hardly any of them. But, yeah, most of my carry weight before was was potions, and we're gonna resist more fire. Those are gonna dump in. We're gonna get rid of you. We're gonna get rid of you. We're gonna get rid of you. Oops. Resist poison. Yeah, I made a whole bunch of crap. Restore health. Okay. Yeah, these are virtually the same thing, but yeah. Yeah, one's got 93 points, the other has 92. That's because my alchemy skill improved, so my potions got a little bit stronger as I was making them. True shot, those are kind of weak at this point. Ultimate healing, gotta have those. Ultimate stamina, gotta have those. Magicka, fuck that. You know, I don't really need those. I'll keep my white file, of course. Growling poison. Okay, so carry weight much better. I have pretty much what I want. I guess I'll keep the some of these poisons just in case I need them. Like the slow might be pretty good. Plus it does extra damage to the target. So that might be good too. I'll keep the blocking just in case, and the health one, I guess, just in case. Oh wait, I don't need all these. Let's go with, yeah, that'll do it. So yeah, I got potions that help with one-handed, two-handed. Do I need 33 though? you know, if I need more, I can always take them out of storage later. So that'll work. So yeah, I made it to level 57. As you can see, it was kind of weird because, like, as soon as I maxed out alchemy, that's right when I hit level 57. It was, like, perfect. And as far as my health, yeah, I put the last two levels into health because, because it'll help me survive. I mean, at this point, I'm kind of getting to a point where stamina doesn't really matter as much. I mean, my survival matters more than the amount of stamina I have, so. And I don't always have access to, corpses, you know, to eat, because, you know, with Namira's ring equipped. So it's kind of like, okay, well, I need to, figure out, you know, how to survive a little easier, you know, because I still die. You know, I'm still getting killed by, you know, enemies that use a lot of elemental attacks because, again, my character is not really geared for elemental defense.
Women are vain for trying to look good. Just because men are lazy and don't even bother having a watch doesn't mean we are vain.
Alright, after all that, definitely need to save. Okay, just had to check to see if I truly was recording. Sometimes, I hit the hotkey on my keyboard and it doesn't record. Or it doesn't start or stop recording. I don't know why that happens sometimes, but it's pretty annoying. Easy fix though, I just close the program, open it back up again, and it works, but yeah, sometimes, man, shit doesn't work. It's just the way it goes. Oh, you know what? I never talked about my perks that I took, or my other perk that I took. Yeah, I took the stimulants perk. When you use a beneficial potion or ingredient, you regenerate 2% of your magicka and stamina per second for 30 seconds. Well, the stamina part of this is good, but basically I want to start up this this path right here. This will also be good. It'll give me more movement speed. But ultimately, this ability right here, when you use a beneficial potion or ingredient, 50% chance to receive a powerful side effect, randomly chosen from a range of 40 side effects. The whatever the hell that means, I have no idea. I guess it's something good, but that's not really why I want to go up this path. I want to get this right here. When you shout, your blood turns poisonous for 15 seconds. The next time you get hit with a weapon, retaliate with a powerful poisonous strike that deals 50 points of poison damage per second for 10 seconds. So that's 500 damage over 10 seconds. That is damn good. The only thing about this is, it's poison. So undead are not going to be affected by it. But everything else that doesn't have a resistance to poison is going to be affected by this, so that should be really good. Oh, and then there's this perk right here. Upon learning this perk, you imbibe a deadly toxin, taking 150 damage per second. So let's do the math. 1, 2, 3, that's 450 points of damage over 3 seconds. Use a couple potions, you know, keep yourself alive. If you survive for 60 seconds, you receive 3 perk points and a permanent 25% bonus to all potions and poisons you make. That's pretty good. That's damn good if you can survive for a minute taking 150 damage per second, but damn, that is a lot of damage per second. So yeah, I might get this perk later, but yeah, mainly I want to get World Serpent. That one looks like it's going to be really good. was easy. Ultimate healing potions, not that extreme healing shit. Although I guess I shouldn't complain. Just more healing potions. They'll keep me alive. But, yeah, I got plenty of healing potions now to help me get by. Hopefully. That way I can hopefully, save my good ones for emergencies. Take a lexicon, then. I don't think so, man. I could do better than that, really. Yeah, let's go with Dwarven arrows. Yes. I like easy targets. I'll just go up and whack them with my sword, but all these elemental attacks are just too much for me to handle. Uh-oh. I'm trying to bring these things to life, eh? I wonder. Oh. look, it's Drunman. I think it's one of the guys we saw in the flashback. Whatever the hell we were watching. Sucks to be him. Should have stayed with the others.
We are close now. Can you hear the lexicon calling out?
Sure.
So we grab it and we get out, right?
Once we have the lexicon, we'll need to take it to its podium. I know what to do from there. Soon, the lexicon's knowledge will be mine.
Ours. Soon, the lexicon's knowledge will be ours.
Of course.
Those guys, man. Okay, so this is the last floor. So we're getting pretty close to our objective here. What will happen when we do something with this lexicon here? Who knows? I've never done this quest.
there. I can hear the lexicon. Come on, quickly.
Something doesn't feel right. Wait!
His tail is still moving. Okay, that's kind of weird. Could feed on their corpses, but nah. Unless he's not a corpse, unless he's just unconscious right now. I better take the dynamo cores. I don't know if I need them for some later or not. Bummer, man. There should be one more person, right? Okay. What does that do? I didn't complete the quest, did I? It said I had to return. Okay, I'm utterly confused now. What the hell was the point of doing that? I better go talk to that, whoever it is in Riften. Oh, wait. That person in Riften is probably the one I got the lexicon from. She probably left and was like all scared out of her mind that she went, so she went crazy and shit, maybe. I don't know. Get out of here. Wasn't that thing supposed to take me back to the beginning? Did I just go the wrong way? Oh, man. Oh, wait. Is that the, oh, that's a boilery. Balcony? Yeah, let me go out the balcony. Just get me the fuck out of here.
Sometimes you think the Dwemer anticipated our arrival. Why else would they make this place so different?
Last time I came out here, too. Fuck. Hey, horsey, did you miss me? Alright. Now we're gonna go to Golden Glow Estate. I believe is my next target, right? I'm sorry, my fucking throat is messed up. I don't know why my voice is cracking like that. I sound like a goddamn... I sound like a fucking teenager again. Throat's dry, though, that's what it is. Burn the beehives. Yeah. Okay. I think I'm just gonna jump in the water. Bodyguard again.
I wasn't laughing at your stupidity.
Where are all these bad guys coming from all of a sudden?
Like wild dogs. You're not going to start doing the thing with my leg, are you?
chance again. Let me talk to him. Hey. Hey, fool.
Hmm?
You want something from me?
Yeah, I want your bodyguard to stop attacking us. These Thalmor guys attacking me. Goodness, it got freaking crazy. What the? the hell? What's going on with her right now? Holy shit. That's why that guy seemed as strong as fuck. Glass armor if you want it. I don't even care. Wow. That was a crazy ass battle, man. There was like fucking 15 Thalmor soldiers, man. And a super boss. But hey, I got the last laugh, right? Wasted a lot of my health potions. Should have went in there as a fucking werewolf.
Have you ever thought that our lives are just one big game? Like, someone is sitting there playing with us, like some adult plaything?
How many potions do I have left? Hope I still got quite a few left. Oh yeah. Okay, I'm still good.
No, I don't mean that kind of adult. It makes you think, though.
Better save after that. That was intense. Hmm. 45. Actually, with only 45, I'll come back. I'll save whatever this is for the next video, actually. Start on it now. Gotta do something I can do fast. I think that's the first time ever in this game that I've had like four bears attack me at once. I think that's a first. I don't think that's ever happened before. Not that it matters, of course. Pretty easy to take out. That Spriggan guy, on the other hand, though, that was a little dangerous. That fucking ability, whatever ability they used to drain my health. I remember correctly, Fort Greenwall was the was one of the quests I had to do for the companions, I think. Come here, you.
Is it me, or are the priests in Skyrim all perverts? I said I had injured my leg, and one of them told me to remove my clothes. So he could use his healing hands on
Shore of Stone.
Needless to say, he needed a bit of healing himself after that.
Of course. Fucking, is there an inn in this area? Ooh, a smelter. Very nice. Fuck, man, it's only 2 a.m.
Let's get going.
Sucks, man. Why's it gotta be nighttime? I can't wait either, because I'm outside. And I don't want to break in, because that would be, uncouth of me. Could use this fucking thing. Why don't I show this off?
Let me guess. Are you saying you don't trust me?
While I'm waiting.
Fair point, actually. I wouldn't trust me.
While I am waiting, I will show off the smelter. Where's all my ingots? Or my ores, actually. I need ores. Grab a whole bunch of ores.
All right, then.
So, this is the smelter right here. You can... Oh, wait. I can't... do this without, Damn, that sucks.
Do you have something to say? Is it because you're scared what I might do with it?
I know I can at least do iron ore. I should be able to do that, right? God, I got so much crap. Okay.
Let's not hang around then.
Okay, this is how you turn ores into ingots.
What can I do for you, friend?
And with the mod I have installed, it raises up your smithing. Why is this relevant? Well, it's an easy way to level up. As you can see. Again, I don't understand for the life of me why in the vanilla Skyrim this has nothing to do with the leveling process.
Always born and ages stuck together? I just don't get it. I swear, there must be some kind of conspiracy.
I'm here to help.
Was there something? Are you saying you don't trust me? Fair point, actually. I wouldn't trust me.
I could also. Now, basically, what you gotta do for the other ores, I guess you gotta invest in the perks. Yeah, like you gotta invest in this one here, do steel and bone mold, and then you gotta do this one, do elven and chitin. And dwarven, apparently. Scale plate, Nordic orcish. Glass crystalline, ebony stalk, yeah. Got all these different types of smithing perks. I don't know what the second point actually does, though, I have no idea. Oh, investing a second perk lets you lets you choose both. Okay, I gotcha. So you get to choose which one that you you want to specialize in. See, I don't know if I'm even gonna invest. Yeah, I might. I want to level this up just so I got a level, but I don't know if I. At this point, I don't know if I'm gonna invest any perks in it. And all that stuff. If there's one perk that I'm particularly interested in, it's probably this one right here. Arcane Blacksmith. Because I'd like to improve my Daedric artifacts if I can. I don't know if that... if I need other perks in order to do that. Or not. I'm not really sure. Anyway, I'm going to end the video right here, and in the next episode, I'm going to do something here. What do I got to do here again? Obtain ore sample. Yeah, I'm going to obtain this ore sample, and then, maybe I'll kill the dragon up here, too. That should be pretty easy to do, actually. Yeah, I'll do that. Yeah. I'll do this, and then I'll do that at the start of the next episode, and then if I have time, I'll go over here and do this. So there you go. See you next time. Bye-bye.